Stamboni, you came up with this, and I like it because it seems to have caught fire a little bit. Simple question. What is no longer worth it because it's become prohibitively expensive? Something you used to enjoy doing, buying, wearing, eating. But now you go, you know what? I can't. It's become too expensive. Scott, there was one that reminded me of you, made me think you enjoy more than anybody else going to shows, going to concerts. And let me scroll down and find this. Steve Rudden says, concerts, I can't anymore. I was paying $10 tickets, $15 tickets. And now inflation plus some of these shows, it's so prohibitively expensive for the everyman to go to like a big AAA show. In some cases, like easy, like, I can't go anymore. Concerts.
Yeah, I mean, but how often are you going? Like, I only go to, at this point in my life, a select few concerts a year. They got to be, either I'm getting tickets through here, which very never happens, or I will pay. Like, I just went to go see Tyler Childers, and I paid $100 a ticket. And I was like, you know what, I'm fine with that, because I really want to see him. And I haven't been to a concert since. I probably won't go to another concert until sometime next year. But yes, I mean that's up to $100 is $100.
Remember that was the hill Eddie Vedder was trying to die on back in the late 90s, early 2000s. He was like fighting back against venues and Ticketmasters of the world, being like, whoa, we want a $20 ticket. Our fans are kind of living check to check. People want to hear even flow without having to go into debt or sell their ass on the corner. Who's the who's the guy? That Appalachian singer that everybody fell in love with for like 2 weeks and now no one's talking about anymore.
Oliver Anthony.
That guy is doing that now where he's like turning down venues to have him play if the ticket is any more than $25. Ticketmaster was getting sued because it was like, oh, okay, the ticket's $80. You buy two, should be $120 plus taxes, $922. Like, whoa, what? And then you go and see the taxes and the fees and the processing charges. You know, it's one that's starting to price themselves out of the market. Airbnb. Airbnb is starting to become prohibitively expensive. I know I'm not saying that right. It's starting to get the cleaning fees, the processing fees. We were looking into doing a little ski snowboard trip with the DLP boys in January. We're looking for some Airbnbs. A hotel is 100% more worth it.
Yeah.
100% more worth it. You and your boys dealt with that on the guys trip.
Well, that was a different scenario, but that was because they don't allow you to, a lot of cities now don't allow just weekend Airbnb rentals. You have to rent for like a whole week.
Edwin says, drinking at sports events, concert venues. Yeah. I'll go to the sport, I'll go to the concert, but to enjoy concessions there, I just can't.
I mean, I just went to the Orioles playoff game. I don't even know how much a beer costs normally, but they were like, $14 or something.
It's like movie theater pricing.
It's like a $14 beer. I'm like, what?
Here's one that's probably landed at every Marylander's feet. I love you. Ocean City Mayor Rick Meehan, you need to talk to local businesses. An Ocean City beach vacation the summer, it's absurdly
now
expensive.
Now people are going to like Jamaica instead because it's cheaper,
yes,
or comparable.
They're going on cruises. All you can eat. What are the all-inclusives? Yeah, they're going to the islands and stuff like that. I took the family there just for a little two-night stay. It was like 400-something a room for a hotel that was built in the 70s. Like, the wall was damp.
Yeah.
It was not what I needed it to be. It's Ocean City, brother. No, your customer base. What has become just too expensive? It's not worth it anymore. Can't do it. Done. I used to love to eat here, wear that, go there. We got a lot of basic ones. Healthcare, I get it. Owning a home has become too expensive. It's not worth it. I mean, I know they're always going, hey, buy a house. It's a good investment. It's hard to do just to get the damn thing. Home prices and the American income have not increased via inflation parallel. One has gone way up and the other has crept upwards.
Somebody just says going out in Baltimore is out of control. Used to be able to go out 3 or 4 times a week. Oh, my God. Used to be able to go out 3 or 4 times a week and still make rent. Now you have to limit it to maybe 1 or 2 times a week. The hell are you going out 3 or 4 times a week for?
Look at you. Oh, what's up, Trucker John? Thank God we don't do this. This is one of the reasons that Josh has been pointing out accurately so that Joe Stamboni is broke and will soon be destitute. Cigarettes. Not worth it anymore. Every week, Trucker John spends $220 on two cartons of cigarettes, one for the old lady. You spend $220 a week. That's $880 a month. That is like, that's like a studio apartment's rent.
Yeah, I was in like, I guess it had to be a drugstore, right? They still sell cigarettes. Or yes. No, maybe it was a 7-Eleven. But a guy bought a carton of cigarettes. And I hadn't heard the word carton of
carton.
The phrase carton of cigarettes in probably 30 years. I was like, I forgot cartons of cigarettes still exist.
Here's
what is it? Is it 20 packs of cigarettes?
I'm glad I don't know. Hold on. How many?
My dad used to, like, when I was younger, my dad used to smoke. I remember he used to buy cartons of cigarettes.
How many packs are in a carton of cigarettes? 10. A standard carton of cigarettes contains 10 individual packs of 20 cigarettes each, so 200 cigarettes. Damn.
That's a lot of cigarettes.
Jasmine, what's up? As stunning as I remember, give the better half a peck on the cheek for me. Thrifting? They're putting a fresh coat of paint. What do I say? We live in the nostalgia economy right now. The thrift stores are starting to get smart. They're becoming vintage clothing outlets. It's just someone's old farted up in Dockers that used to be able to, you know, get some a pair of slacks for a buck, an old coat. You're going in there getting your Macklemore on, popping tags. Why would I pay $20 for boots with scratches all over them when I can go to the shoe store and get a new pair for the same price? Some of these vintage places that are like, okay, it's your grandmother's old, you know, nightgown. Oh, but it's vintage.
Somebody says Hot Wheels. They used to be 96 cents. Now they're $1.08.
You see what Midday Host on?
$1. They went up 12 cents.
It's disgusting. It's one of the reasons we still appreciate that Costco hot dog. That Costco hot dog meal. They dug their heels in on that. That thing should be $8 at this point with the drink and the chips and all that. Now, $1.29. Or is it $39? TJ Smith says getting hash browns at one of my favorite fast food establishments used to be $1. Now it's $3.
Wow. Really?
That sucks. Brittany, what's up, sweet Brit? Just living. Everything is so expensive. Food and housing are starting to become luxuries instead of necessities. I mean, you're starting to see, I was, you know, bitching about Ocean City getting expensive. Ocean City was expensive. Japan was paid off pretty quickly. I'm still digging a little bit at Disney. I got a little bit more to pay off the Disney trip from more than, it's coming up on 2 years. Go to the other side of the planet.
It's a great one, Disney.
It's gotten crazy over there. And you see that their attendance is going down because just the nuclear family, maybe husband, wife, two kids, half a dog, that they can't afford. They can't afford to get there.
Now, you go there and you see families that, like, this is their lifetime trip.
It's the one time they go.
Yeah.
You look at it and go, none of you have sleeves. None of you have sleeves.
They save for 10 years. This is their one time trip, and that's all they can afford.
The baby smoking. Speaks, you're a guy who, you know, you're frugal yet generous with your friends. You enjoy ordering out from time to time. Have you noticed, ordering out? Is it getting prohibitively expensive yet?
They're a bunch of crooks, thieves, gonoffs.
Gonoffs?
They're just looking to, it's highway robbery. Yeah, they treat me like I don't know what's going on. I know what's going on, I'll tell you.
It's one of the reasons I'll get a little Indian food now and then, get some Chinese food if I don't feel like doing a big football spread. I'll get the beef and broccoli, I'll get the General So's, I'll get the lo mein, house, no veggies. And it'll come out to be about $40.
Yeah.
And it all lines up. Yes, that one dish is $9, that's $9, that's $12. Dude, I'll get like a pizza from somewhere. Like, oh, cool, it's the $10.99 dinner box deal. $10.99 after taxes, maybe a tip, $20. $42.50. Like, what the hell?
You know what else?
What's that?
Prostitutes.
Oh, man.
Used to be $800.
For around the world.
Used to be?
$1,400
now. Damn. What? You getting that platinum package.
Yeah. Are you doing everything? Catching the day? Soup course?
You getting the undercarriage and the tire shine. What? Damn, son.
You getting the service entrance and the main gate?
Hanging them upside down from the ceiling over the bed?
Mm-hmm.
That's $1,900.
Yeah, it's extra.
It's called the Count Crackula.
Yeah.
Upside down.
Oh, God.
You smell like an awful cereal.
Just for the record, I don't purchase prostitutes, but I do look at them.
You got something in your eye? You're winking quite a bit.
Fingers are crossed.